Hi, I got this product from Banggoods. This is my new BLDC motor controller. You are already familiar with my old controller. Now, the differences between the two are this one comes with a good case and a pre-installed heatsink. Unlike this one, I had to set it all up. Now, this controller ranges from 20 to 50 volts DC and up to 12 amperes, which is rated, and 15 amperes is the peak. While this one is rated for 15 amperes, but the voltage rating is only 12 to 36 volts DC. And finally comes the power capability. This one is 500 watts and this one is 600 watts. Although this controller does not come with the reverse switch, you have to add it yourself. Now let's have a closer look at its build quality. You can see how thick the heat sink is that they have used. That's the inside view of the circuit, and that's the provision for your hall type of motors. Now let's start with the connections. Here, if you see, those are the grooves, and here we have the points, so it's going to go like this. Next comes the DC input. You see positive and negative from my variable 24 volts power supply. Now the power supply has been connected to the controller and it is going to feed in 24 volts maximum to my controller. Also, for testing, I'm going to use this 24 volts 400 watts wind turbine generator as the BLDC motor here. So starting with the test, first turning on this power supply to the max, and here we have the indication. Now let's turn this one, because I'm not sure if it is turned on or not. Nope, I'll have to turn it on. Yeah, it's on. And now, yeah, and it has started running. So let's increase the speed. Now let's turn it off. Yeah, it's closed. Reducing it to zero. Turning it on. Increasing. Let's go max. That's full. Now this motor is 24 volts, but it is designed for a very low RPM because it is a wind turbine generator, which you already know. Now moving on to this 24 volts 500 watts e-rickshaw motor. So this is a high current one. Let's test it. So let's see if this power supply is strong enough to handle this kind of load. And same goes for the controller. That's to the minimum. Starting it, it's on. Slowly and slowly, it's running. Let's increase the speed. It's actually quite nice. The torque is also really good. Wow. More? Oh, it's really nice. More? That's quite a high speed, but we don't have enough amperes coming in from the power supply. It is only 3 amperes from the power supply maximum. Let's go full. And here, if you can see how the voltage has dropped from 24 volts to 22 volts, which means that it is consuming full amps from the power supply. And if I'm going to stop it or put my finger over here, the voltage is going to reduce further because it is not able to provide enough current to the motor. You see, 21, 20. So the torque is really nice and the controller is awesome. So here we have an amazing controller, brushless controller capable of handling load of up to 600 watts. This is a 500 watts motor. This can handle 48 volts or max of 50 volts and 600 watts. Unlike the previous one, which was this one, this was 500 watts. And also the maximum voltage of this controller was only 36 volts. And this one is 50 volts, as I already told you. Now let's connect a power supply that is big enough to handle that much current. Now I'm going to use this huge power supply from an old printer. Let's have a look at its label. It's 32 volts and 5.6 amperes. So this is the biggest one that I have with high voltage as well as high current. So I've turned on the power supply. As you can see the indication there, turn the switch on. Okay, increasing more, 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 super high speed, but we are still not at full. It's a pretty huge speed. Yeah, super high torque. Let's go more. Oh. Let's increase further. Oh, the speed is so high. Let's go more. So that's the maximum speed, a very high speed. Now, despite of all the pros of this controller, there is still one important thing missing, a switch for changing the direction of rotation of the motor. So before connecting the switch, you will have to take out the ground wires. After that, take one wire from the switch and connect it along with the rest of the two wires. Done. Now we have one more wire left that will be connected to F/R, which is forward and reverse. And that's it, you are done. Now for demonstrating the direction changing of the motor, I'm going to use this smaller one because it is a low RPM geared motor. So it will be easier for you to see the change in direction. So let's turn on the supply. Okay, now we have three switches. This is on off. This is for changing the direction and this is for changing the speed or speed control. So let's start with this one. Slow starting. Yeah, so at present it is running in the anti-clockwise direction. Now let's reverse it, turning the speed to zero. Add the reverse switch that we just connected. It's on. Now let's see if it is clockwise this time. Yeah, and we are clockwise this time. So now our BLDC motor controller is fully complete. It has reverse, it has stop switch, and it has speed regulation. So guys, that's all for this video today. And link to buy this product has been provided in the description. You can check it out from there. So see you in the next one. Hit like and don't forget to share and subscribe. Bye bye. Hi, today I'm going to do a really interesting experiment using the device I got from DF Robot. So let's open it up and see what is inside. Also, link to buy this product has been provided in the description. You can check it out from there. So anyways, this is a wireless energy transmission device with a transmitter and a receiver end. This what you see is a 12 volts bulb and I'm going to connect it to the receiver. And to power up the transmitter, here I'm going to use this 9 to 24 volts power supply. So now that everything is set, let's turn on the supply. It's full 24 volts, although the bulb is not lighting up. Let's bring them close and see. Oh, yeah, now it's working. Nice. Although here we can see this small LED lighting up. I'm going to give you a closer view on that. You see that small red LED? So it is glowing, indicating that it is receiving signals from the transmitter, but the signals are not strong enough to light up this big bulb. So guys, I've done this setup in which this is the transmitter and I've held it with this clip, and the receiver, the coil is held with the other clip. Now here I'm going to do the distance measurement at which this bulb is going to glow. Turning it on. And the bulb is not glowing right now, so I will have to bring them closer. Oh yeah, and it has started glowing a little bit, so I'm going to turn off the lights. It's going to help you see it more clearly, and now you can see the bulb is glowing. It's very dim. Let's bring it a little more close. Yeah, and now it's much brighter. More. Yeah, okay, so that's the distance. Now it's fully bright. Here I'm going to do this coil distance measurement test. So here, as you can see, that at 22.5 millimeters it is giving out full potential output, so it's around 2.2 centimeters. Now let's try some smaller loads like a CPU fan. Turning the switch on, it's running. Let's increase the distance. Yeah, and this time the distance is much more than before, and it is still running. Let's see the maximum distance capability. Oh, that is pretty huge. Let's go more. See, it's fallen down, but the fan is still running. So that's the transmitter circuit, and the distance between the coils is also huge. And here, as you can see, that the receiver LED is glowing, indicating the incoming power, and the fan is also running. Now let's measure the distance between the coils. So here we have 84 millimeters, which means 8 centimeter. That is pretty good. Now, as you can see, that right now the bulb is not glowing, and here I have this ferrite core, so I am going to place it inside the coil and let's see if it glows this time. You see that it is glowing, and if I remove it, then it is still glowing but much lesser in brightness. So the ferrite core increases the induced flux. Now let's use this ferrite core and move it in between like this. It's getting dim. Yeah, it's completely out. Yeah, not glowing at all, but this one increases the flux linkage somehow. If I go all the way through, it is still working. In the middle, it is the brightest. Let's bring the coils closer. Okay, like without the ferrite core, you can see that it is glowing this much. Let's bring it close, and the brightness has reduced a little bit. See, this was the initial and it has reduced. Now let's move along to the middle. It is much more bright this time. Now let's proceed further. Yeah, it has reduced. Middle, brightest. Okay, so that's the effect of the ferrite core, the cylindrical one. Although something happens with this one, as soon as I put it in the middle, it turns off completely. Okay, nothing. If I bring them closer, so it's logged to the maximum brightness.
Hi guys, you're watching channel Mr. Electron, and in this video I'm going to review this cordless 2-in-1 electric handheld grass shear hedge trimmer Eve Age series. As you can see that it works quite well, so let's connect it to a charger. The red light indicates that it has started charging. So after an hour here, as you can see that the light has turned green, indicating full charge. Now let's test it.